Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. And in this video, I'm going to show you 5 tricks in Photoshop that you probably don't know. Like if you go into edit toolbar option and hold shift and then click done, your edit toolbar option turns into a banana. Yeah, it's a really cool trick to show off, but without that, it's pretty useless. So now let's get into the real tricks. So here we have a beautiful image of a horse, but the aspect ratio of the image is 2:3. Now if I want to post it in Instagram, I can't post that because Instagram doesn't allow 2:3, so I have to crop it in 4:5. So let's go into crop tool and select 4:5, but as you guys can see, we are losing some space on background and also in foreground. But I don't wanna lose any space. But if I don't want to leave any space, I have to deal with the bars in both of the sides. But if I tick the content aware field and then press done, now Photoshop is going to perform content aware in both of the empty spaces, and Photoshop is going to give us a really beautiful image like that. And as you guys can see, Photoshop has done a really good job in both of the sides, and now we have a 4:5 aspect ratio image, and we can post it on Instagram without any problem. Okay, so after doing some basic adjustments, now you want to adjust all the hue, saturation and all the stuff, and now you are spending time doing all kind of crazy stuff to give it a personal look, and after some time you realize that you have messed it up. So now you have to reset all the values and you have to start all over again, but you don't have any reset option here. Now here is a small trick that you can see. Here is two options, okay and cancel, but if you hold the alt, you can see that the cancel option turns into a reset. Now just click on the reset and all the values are back to zero, and you can now start all over again. You have an image here, and now you want to do some dodge and burning. So just go into the toolbar, select the dodge, and you started dodging. And then choose the burn, and you are done with the dodge and burn. But you have permanently affected your image. So if you now want to go back, you can't go back because it has permanently applied on your image. Now there is a better way to do that. Just take a new layer, fill it with 50% gray, shift plus F5 for fill, 50% gray, and change the blending mode to overlay. Now basically you have a transparent layer over your image. And now do all the dodge and burning on the gray layer. So like I'm dodging and burning this image, but as you guys can see, the everything is applied on the 50% gray layer. So that's a pretty handy, but that will not affect your image. So always try to do dodge and burning on 50% gray layer, as it really helps. And you can also change so many things, adjust so many things even after applying the dodge and burn. Now this is not a very colorful image, but yes, we have some prominent colors in it. But the problem with Photoshop is if you go into the adjustments, you have all types of tools to work on the color balance, to work on hue, saturation, vibrance, brightness, contrast and everything, but you don't have any particular tool to work on luminosity. So let's take a black and white adjustment and select the adjustment layer and change the blending mode to luminosity. And now you can use all the sliders to work on luminosity of your image. While working in Photoshop, the brush tool is the most important tool, but the problem is you have a brush like that. You want to increase the hardness, you have to go here, increase the hardness, and now you have a hard brush. But if you want to decrease the hardness, you have to go back, decrease the hardness. And same with the size, you have to go here, change the size, look into it, and you have to change from here, and now you have it. So it's a bit time consuming and it's not ideal for doing some major projects. Now the trick is, press and hold the Alt on your keyboard and click the right click of your mouse. And now if you move your mouse in right direction, you are increasing the brush size, and if you move your mouse in the left direction, you are decreasing the size. And also the same with the hardness, if you drag your mouse downwards, you are increasing the hardness, and if you are dragging your mouse upwards, you are decreasing the hardness. So that's it for today's video, and I hope you have found something useful. If you like the video, please hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe to watch more videos like that. And if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section down below. See you guys in the next one. Till then, tada.